there's a lot of good artists in Punjab. Sartaj is doing really well over there right now.
Right.
Gurdas Mann Sahib has been a huge inspiration.
He's legend. Right from the start. Yeah.
So, you know, to be able to work with someone like that would be amazing. On the Western side of stuff, I mean, we like to kind of catch on to the very kind of cutting edge trends and stuff. So, the kind of latest trends right now that are happening are dubstep,
right,
and just kind of global bass music, electronic music. So, you know, we're catching on with the trends. So, you know, the next kind of batch of material, even the stuff that we're pushing into Bollywood, has that influence in there.
Right.
So, you know, we're just trying to keep it fresh, and, you know, trying to fuse, you know, what we can do with our grounding in British music and contemporary electronic music, Western music, with, you know, our roots, heritage, or the kind of Asian side of things.
That's cool. Now, Tiger Style, obviously, you guys are like the pioneers of the mashup genre. Like, you know, just bringing two different things together and just making it sound off the hook. Like, Nachna Ondini was one of the biggest hits in Asia. And even now, that song is like still playing like mad on the radio. I mean, we still play it here on Radio 1 FM 91, Nachna Ondini. What a classic track. And even on Britain's Got Talent, there was a group called Signature who came on stage and performed on that. And, you know, they got like massive feedback from all over the world. Now, how do you, like, now, you guys still enjoy doing mashups? Do you guys still enjoy bringing two songs together and making it your own sound?
Not so much these days, because a lot of our focus right now is on making original music.
Right.
Like mashup kind of ideas are good, but they only have a certain shelf life.
Right.
And
no doubt.
Most of the time it's dependent on the songs that you use to mash up, you know?
Right.
So unless you're mashing up a classic like Billie Jean or something, which is impossible to clear the sample.
True. True. You guys totally get props for that. I just want to say, you totally get props for that.
Cheers. So, I mean, you know, with the mashup thing, it's always a very kind of limited shelf life. Whereas if you are bringing a fusion of two different sounds together, like, you know, like say a few years back, we were asked to collaborate with some reggaeton artists and provide remixes.
Right,
reggaeton artists.
Like there was this rumor. I don't know if it's true. We read it somewhere that you were approached to do the remix for Gasolina by Daddy Yankee.
Yeah.
The
label behind the whole kind of movement of reggaeton breaking in the States had approached us to. And at that point, we didn't even know who Daddy Yankee was.
Okay.
We had an email come through, and
right.
You know, I read the email and I was like,
"Who's Daddy Yankee?"
Funny, you know, what the hell is this guy called Daddy Yankee?
So
my reply to the email was, "Can you tell me more about your artist?" You know, and
they probably went, "What?"
Yeah, I mean, the A&R now that we dealt with is huge,
right,
you know, on
right.
the dance scene,
right.
As a DJ and as a producer himself. But at the time, you know, I didn't get a response from him because obviously he was thinking, "Well, what the hell? You know, this is a big artist here, and these guys are asking who is this guy?"
Right.
So we didn't get a response for about a month after kind of sending that initial email. And then I saw the Gasolina video on the MTV in the UK,
right.
And that's when it clicked to me that maybe we've kind of passed up this huge opportunity.
Right.
So I got back in touch with the same A&R guy from the label, and he was like, "Look, well, we didn't know that whether you guys would be interested or not, so we passed up on the Gasolina remix."
But you guys have worked with people like Wisin and Yandel and Don Omar.
Yeah. Looney Tunes was in Yandel, Don Omar, all the top end reggaeton artists, you know, from that genre. We've remixed, you know, their kind of top tunes, because what they felt was that reggaeton is a club sound. It's from Puerto Rico.
Right.
It culminates everything that is Latin, but at the same time, it's a very kind of club and electronic or urban kind of sound.
Right.
And what they felt was, Bhangra at the same time, or UK Bhangra is exactly the same as what reggaeton is for Latin people, what Bhangra is for Punjabi people.
Right, no doubt. Yeah.
So, you know, it was a good fusion, and off that, then, you know, we felt good that we were able to kind of fuse our music with another niche genre and be able to take our music to a wider population.
Right. And now, coming back to Bollywood, now, obviously, Singh is King, the track called Bhootni Ke, which, again, yeah. massive success all over the world in Pakistan. I remember going to a couple of weddings and dancing to this song. And you know, even the groom was looking at me going, dude, the song is about me. You know? So it was really, so it's a great track and it blew up yeah. big. Now, tell us about yeah. working in Bollywood. How's the experience been so far and what have you guys lined up for the future? Are there more Bollywood projects coming up?
Yeah, the Bollywood stuff's been amazing to be working on. I have to give props to Hardcore, a good friend of ours from Birmingham,
right?
Who's now relocated to Bombay, and she's a huge star over there.
Right.
And it's because of her, she went there and she really kind of pushed for the cutting edge new artists to be used for production and remix work in Bollywood, and that's where Preetam got in touch with us and wanted to work with us on the Singh is King remixes and various other remixes and productions.
Right.
So most of the Bollywood stuff that we've done has either been remix work for Preetam for some of his songs, or then actual production work that goes into songs that have been in films. So that's why certain songs in Akrosh, Bilbul Haripa, Ajo Prem Ki Gajab Kahani, Love Ajkal, certain songs, certain original songs have our production.
Brilliant.
And then we obviously, the remixes you hear about anyway because it has our name on it. But when it's a co-production for the actual film, then obviously the credit goes to Preetam. But there's various teams behind Preetam that help along in terms of bringing a song together. So we've been fortunate enough that we've been given the opportunity, to give our ideas and try and kind of push along the music that we make and get it into the film industry.
Right. Okay. Now we're just going to round things up. We've got the last few questions for you guys. One thing I do want to mention is that Tiger Style are probably one of the only few Asian acts in the world to have a live session with late legendary radio presenter, DJ, journalist John Peel. How do you guys feel about that? Like being one of the last few Asian acts to ever record a live session with him?
Yeah, it was amazing. I think the only other Asian act has been Apache Indian.
Right.
If I'm correct, I'm not too clear on that one, but it was a good opportunity, and I feel proud that someone like John Peel, he broke so many different music forms,
right.
And he gave young up and coming artists, new genres, a platform, and it was amazing to be able to be given the opportunity to record our sounds the way we could have done. For Radio 1, for BBC, and for John Peel was amazing.
Right. Okay. Now I just want to ask you guys, what has Tiger Style lined up for the future? What is the next big thing that's coming out from Tiger Style that we're going to hear?
Next big thing for us is we've been working with a Bombay music director called Ram Sampat.
Okay.
Who is providing the film music for Amar Khan's next production.
Wow.
It features Imran Khan.
Okay.
And the film's called Delhi Belly.
Right.
And it comes out in June this year.
That's awesome. We've heard so much about Delhi Belly. That's huge.
Yeah. I mean, because we don't actually get so much film news over here in the UK.
Right.
The way you guys do over there in Pakistan.
Right.
But, from what I've heard is, it's a good project to be involved
it's
in.
It's a big project, bro. So, good luck with that.
So, I mean, we've done one co-production. We've done one remix. And the sound is very cutting edge. There's a bit of a dubstep influence in there with the remix.
Wow.
So there's definitely one to kind of look out for.
That's awesome. I cannot wait to hear it, bro. I cannot wait. And what about your own album and what about your own singles? Because you guys have released many albums. So anything coming up from you guys?
We've been working on a lot of stuff, new material. We have various kind of really big Punjabi artists that we've been working with a lot, as well as the kind of group of artists that we usually work with anyway. We've had singles out with Shizzo,
right.
And Blitzkrieg, we had a Gunjan album out last year. This year we've broken a brand new artist, Sidhu Tajpuri.
Right, right.
We've also got our own new singles coming out hopefully this summer or throughout the rest of the year, and hopefully a brand new album at the start of next year.
That's
so there's a lot to look out for. lot to look forward to.
That's excellent, bro. We cannot wait to get our hands on your album. I'm just going to, the minute I get it, I'm just going to spin it like mad here on Radio 1 for sure.
Cool, man. I feel fortunate that, you know, we're able to connect with you guys in Pakistan.
Right.
And, you know, I feel blessed that, you know, our sound's getting that far.
No doubt, it
that,
is.
You know, people are listening to us and in Pakistan.
Right. Any now, before we let you go, bro, is there anything you want to say to the people of Pakistan, to your fans in Pakistan who are listening to Tiger Style right now on the air? Anything you want to say?
Yeah, I would just love that, you know, the fan base that is listening to our music, if they connect with us in some way. So we're on Facebook, facebook.com/TigerStyleOnline. We're on Twitter, twitter.com/TigerStyleMusic. You can check us out on the website tigerstyleonline.co.uk. These are the kind of main ways to connect with us. I'd be honoured if promoters got in touch and we could line up some shows, maybe do a mini tour of Pakistan.
Bro, I'm telling you, the minute you come down to Pakistan, I'm going to be in the front row. I'm just going to be cheering for you guys. I'm going to be like, what's up?
We do a DJ setup and we also do a live band now.
Wow.
So we've done some shows with the live band in the UK, and we've been out to Sweden as well last year. So, you know, we're looking for opportunities to be able to perform live. So, yeah, definitely, you know, shout out to all the promoters. If there's anyone interested, then definitely get in touch.
For sure. Thank you so much for talking to us live on Radio 1 Pop. It was fantastic. And we wish you guys the best of luck for everything. God bless you guys. And God bless Tiger Style. Take care, man.
Thank you.
All right, take care. Peace out, brother.
Bye.